Hi guys, so this is to explain that question 4. Now question 4, as you can see the video, it's a swinging flashlight test where the light alternates between the left eye and the right eye. Now when the light is on the left eye, you can see that the pupil is brilliantly constricting, briskly constricting. So that means the afferent and the efferent are normal. That is, the afferent, the left optic nerve, and the efferent, the left oculomotor nerve, are absolutely normal. Now when the light goes to the right eye, there is paradoxically a dilatation. So that means it is not able to sustain the indirect reflex that happened when the light was on the left eye. So now when the light is on the right eye, it appears to dilate. That means it is going back to its original size. That is because the right afferent is not normal. So there is a right afferent defect, whereas the left afferent is normal. So there is a right RAPD, right relative afferent pupillary defect. Now this can occur in optic neuritis, in case of extensive retinal detachment, it can occur in AION, anterior ischemic optic neuropathy, but it cannot occur in LGB lesion. It cannot occur in anywhere at the proximal part of the optic tract, the LGB, the optic radiation, or the visual cortex, where the pupillary reflex will be absolutely normal. So that is why the answer here is option C, which is right LGB lesion. Of course, even if I'd given you left LGB lesion, of course not, right? So that was a quick question, a video-based question. I hope you really enjoyed it just as much as I enjoyed creating the question for you. All the best, Bachi.